Because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when they're coming to take your freedoms away.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. Yes, the title is a bit deceptive because this is an issue that I want to reach as many people as possible. And so that's why I said, fucking wetbacks everywhere, because that will attract people that hate racists, and it will attract the racists, and now you'll get some knowledge. This issue came up, this topic rather, came up earlier tonight when I was a guest on Boiler Room Radio with host Jim Funky, and Lance had touched on this, and I was horrified. This is your government. This is what you're about to vote for coming up again. Operation Wetback. I'm horrified that my government does things like this and has this point of view. I really am. Anyway, I'm just going to read a short bit and then link you to it. Something you need to know, something you need to consider. And a point that Lance made on the show was that, you know, if they didn't want the Mexican people coming into the country, they would be able to put up a wall to stop them. We could do that. We have not done that. Why? That's the question you need to answer for yourself. I'm not answering all your questions. Anyway, Operation Wetback was an immigration law enforcement initiative created by the director of the U.S. Immigration and Naturalization Service, Joseph Swing, in cooperation with the Mexican government. So, okay, it's not just our government, it's the global government. The program that was implemented in May 1954 by U.S. Attorney General Herbert Brownell and utilized special tactics to deal with illegal border crossing and residence in the United States by Mexican nationals. It became an issue in the Mexico-United States relations. Ultimately, the program came as a result of the pressure from the Mexican government to stop illegal entry of Mexican laborers in the United States, based largely on the Bracero program. After implementation, Operation Wetback was met with allegations that Mexicans who were arrested and deported by the U.S. Border Patrol had been physically abused and had certain of their civil rights suspended. So anyway, you can read more about it. Pick up the links that are in the wiki.
You can't do these things in my name. You can't do these things in our name.
And unless we rip up the paper that this government is formed from, they're going to continue to violate what is right and true and just in your name at your expense until you decide that you're not going to stand for it anymore. So anyway, I want to link you to Jim's radio program, which is twice a week, Boiler Room Radio, because they really dig into some news that I don't generally cover that you do need to know. And support Jim's effort over there by tuning into his show. He doesn't have archives available, so you can't listen to the show right now, but I think it is something they're working on at Your Cam. But anyway, much love. The link to this will be below. The link to Jimmy will be below. And, I'll see you.